ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम नमो भगवते रमणाय। सर्वैर्निदानं जगतोऽहमश्च वाच्यः प्रभुः कश्चिदपारशक्तिः। चित्रेत्र लोक्यञ्च विलोकिता च पटः प्रकाशोऽप्यभवत् स एकः। सो वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ द वर्स। I feel that the first half of the verse, it has some significant meaning, namely, what you call God or Ishvara need not be a matter of belief alone. Generally, people take Ishvara, Prabhuhu, Ananta Shaktihi, Apara Shaktihi, etc. as a matter of God as a matter of belief. But then, is God a matter of belief? So, not necessary. It need not be a matter of belief. It can be a matter of understanding. Vachyav Prabhuhu Kaschid Apara Shaktihi Sarvaihi. All people, atheists, agnostics, theists, everybody should appreciate that there is a higher power, the prime mover, which moves everything, the outer as well as the inner, without as well as within. Something is moving everything. That prime mover everybody should accept. Now, you should give a name and form to that prime mover. This is the name of that prime mover, which is in this form. That is the belief. There comes the belief. Therefore, the external principles imposed by tradition, etc., they convert an understanding into a belief, which is not necessary. Because in belief, the mind becomes crippled. It stops functioning. And it becomes very mechanical, like a tram car. That is how the mind becomes. On the other hand, in understanding, there is exploration. You always try to find out for yourself. This is how the God belief is not the preferred one. God realization is the preferred approach. So, therefore, you see, if you keep an open mind, so the rishis, the pradas, if only you keep an open mind, you need not just remain at the stage of believing in God. You can as well realize the God. That is the true religion. Therefore, so sarvaihi vachyaha, everybody should accept this much. And having accepted that much, if you proceed on the path of investigation with an open mind, like a scientist, what does a scientist do? He does not prejudge what he is going to find. He does not prejudge. He sees there is a scope for investigation in this area. In this field, there is scope for investigation. And he knows what he knows. And he does not prejudge what he is going to find. And he explores with an open mind. And whatever he finds, he tries to understand it. That is the approach. Whereas, in belief, you prejudge what you are going to find. And what is the basis of that prejudgment? So, somebody believes in Vaishnavism, somebody else believes in Shaivism. If you move across the globe, different groups of people of different parts of the globe, they believe in different forms of God with different names. It is all Namarupa thing it is. And so everybody believes that his belief is superior to the other people's beliefs. Once you put yourself into that, and then call it a tradition. The tradition is what? A frozen thought. Therefore call it a tradition. And some of the so-called traditions are 100-year-old. Some of them are 500-year-old. Like that where everything is a tradition. And so you give some sanctity to the belief. And then and create systems around it. And build a superstructure around the belief. And you submit to yourself to that. In the process, you become like a tram car, and the mind becomes crippled, unable to think. So that is not the path of self-realization or God-realization. That is not the true religion. In the true religion, we start with whatever datum available to us. The available datum is the inner and the outer. Both are moved by the prime mover. They are not self-sufficient. Neither the inner nor the outer are self-sufficient and independent. They are moved by the higher power, whatever may be that higher power. And so now you have to find out that higher power in yourself and discover what it is. So this is what is called self-inquiry, also called Brahma Jijnasa. There is a desire to know the truth. That is what it is. It is not Brahma Jnanam. It is not Athato Brahma Jnanam. It is Athato Brahma Jijnasa. On that basis you proceed. So Maharshi seems to be suggesting something very similar to what I said just now. In that statement, Sarvaihi Vachyaha. Then coming to the second part, Chitretra Lokyancha Vilokitacha Patav Prakashopyabhavatsa Ekaha. So Atra Chitre, Atra is Asmin, Chitre, the movie. Chitre can be a photograph or a painting. That can be called Chitre. But Jagat is a phenomenal world, you know. It is not a static thing. It is not a static universe. It is a dynamic universe. And therefore, the word Chitra has to be understood as a movie. You just cannot take it as a painting. You have to take it as a movie. So that would be better. So this world is called a movie. I have a feeling Shankara talks, he relies upon this illustration of something akin to the movie. Like when he says, Vishwam, the Jagat, Darpana Drishyamana Nagari Tulyam. So he is talking of something which is similar to a modern movie. So you are looking at a city in a mirror. Whatever that how could you manage that? That is not the point. There is a mirror which reflects a city. So a city is reflecting in the mirror. And this Jagat is like that. So except for that moving part, it comes very close to a movie. And here, now we are looking at what Sri Kavyakanta Ganapati Muni has written. By then, there are movies already in place. Maybe I think so. So by then probably movie has become known. It was discovered already. A movie camera was discovered by Thomas Alva Edison. And then movies became slowly popular. And it was Dada Saheb Phalke who has introduced the first movie into the Indian society in Bollywood, in Bombay. And then it was coming to the South also. By then a thing called movie must have been in vogue. So Kavyakanta Ganapati Muni must have known that movie. And what you call the movie? Chitram. But then they call it Chalana Chitram. The Chitra, the movie that the whatever appears on the screen, it is not static, it is moving. So that is the movie. Asmin Chitre. So this movie called the world. So now the world is a movie. So you see, what is a world? What you call world? What is it? I suggest what you call world is but a collection of memories. That is what it is. So therefore, mental states, they succeed one another. These mental states, they are taken as though outside. So like you see the serpent on the rope, and now the serpent seems to be outside. Serpent is in the mind. This is what is called projection. So the serpent which is in the mind is projected onto the rope. Here what is happening, the word projection, that is the right word, because the serpent is not where you see. The serpent you see on the rope, but it is not there. It is in the mind. And from the mind, it is projected outside, adhyaropa, it is projection. And if you go to a movie, that instrument through which they project a movie on the screen, they also call it projection. And they call it, the instrument, they call it projector. So the very right usage of the terms, it looks like that. Anyway, so this movie called The World, so it is a how in movie what happens? The scenes are succeeding one another. A succession of scenes on the screen. That is what is called a movie. Now, Jagat is also a succession of mental states. Now, mental states means you must be seeing the movie inside you, but you don't see the movie inside you. This movie called Jagat, you don't see it inside. Whatever is inside you, you project it outside and see as though in the outside. That is the projection. Therefore, the mind is inside you. Mind is limited to the body. The mind, the volume of the mind is the volume of the body. And the mental states are inside you, but they are seen outside, like the serpent. The serpent which is inside you, you see it outside. This is the Maya, you know. Therefore, in a way, you can nicely compare it with the movie very clearly. In the movie also, you see the heroine or the hero, the actor who is very well known to you, and he is playing a particular role, etc. You see, all of that, do you have it on the screen? The particular actor, is he on the screen or is he in your mind? He is in the mind only. What people do, they carry some flowers when the actor whom they like very much, this fans, you know, they carry flowers and all that and throw onto the screen where the hero appears. But the hero is not on the screen. The hero is in their head, like serpent. Therefore, whatever is in your head, you project it outside and see outside. Like you say, my son. The son is in the head. Son is not outside. Outside, whatever is there. To make it easier to understand, you can say outside there is a human being or a young man. That much you can say. But what you project is you call him the sun. That sun is in your head, in your mind, and that you project outside. Therefore, just like in a movie, you have a succession of scenes. Similarly, when you wake up, this movie called the world begins. And there are successive mental states within you, and those mental states you project outside. And so this is what is called idealism, the philosophy of idealism. It is entirely inside you and you project it outside. This is how it is presented. So this is the Jagat. It is Chitra. Chalana Chitra. Chitratva Maropitam. Chalana Chitra. So the same thing happens in the dream also. In the dream, you see the dream world outside of you, but really speaking, the dream world, all of it is in you, but you see as though you are outside, it is outside of you. And you see a division between you, the dreamer, and the dream world. But really speaking, the dreamer as well as the dream world, both are contained in the same dream consciousness. They are not outside. Any one of them is not outside the dream consciousness. The dreamer is part of the dream consciousness. The dreamt world is also part of the dream consciousness. Therefore, the same consciousness appears as the subject as well as the object. Therefore, the truth doesn't lie in the subject-object duality. The truth is in the light in which this duality comes to light. That is the way you have to understand. Therefore, jagati chitratvam aropitam. You see, just realize that you are dreaming a dream which you call the world. That is how it is. You are dreaming a dream, and the waking state is also a dream. So, you are dreaming a dream that you call the world. And also, when you wake up from the dream, when you see the dream as a dream, so that is all you have to do. See the dream as a dream. You have done all that needs to be done. And the dream vanishes. It doesn't bother you anymore. So there is no action or any effort involved in that. You should be able to see the dream as the dream. The moment you see the dream as the dream, you have already woken up. The same thing you have to do with reference to this dream called the world. Okay? So, asmin chitre jagati chitratvam aropitam. So this chalana chitra, this moving the moving thing is the movie, which is called the jagat. So in this, there are a few things. So, chitre atra lokyancha vilokita cha pataha prakashaha. So many things are there. Now you see, you are saying that the world is a movie, a passing show. So, this is one thing people have to carefully understand. The world is a show. It's a dikhavat. It is a show. Very glittering, but empty. That is what the world is. So, it appears as though it is. As it appears, we tend to take it as ease. Like the serpent appears, you do not say, a serpent appears, you end up saying a serpent is. Ease is not established, only appearance is there. So, but appearances are taken to be real. This is how it happens. They say, you see, asti siddhaha bhati siddhaha. So, that which is established as is, asti siddhaha, that which is established as appearing, bhati siddha. Now the serpent, is it bhati siddha or asti siddha? It is bhati siddha, it is not asti siddha. Similarly, the jagat is bhati siddha, not asti siddha. And that's why here the jagat is called chitra. I added the word chalana, chalana chitra, a movie. So, it appears. And because it appears, the appearance is very absorbing also. We get absorbed in what appears on the screen. And therefore, we end up taking it as is. Therefore, you can simply say it appears as is, but really speaking, it is not. Also, very interestingly, this world movie, it is there as long as you want to take part in it. The moment you lose interest, it ceases, it ends. It is like the movie. Once I went to a movie, I was very tired all through the day, and halfway through the, sometime through the movie, I dropped into sleep. I dozed off and went into sleep. Then there is no movie anymore. And then I woke up. And something is still going on. Then I try to catch up with what is going on. The jagat is like that. When you take part in it, it appears as though real, but once you stop taking part in it, once you lose interest in it, it just vanishes. This is like quantum physics. In quantum physics also it is said that a thing is there only as long as you are observing it. Once you stop observing it, it doesn't exist anymore. Anyway, therefore, when you pay interest in what you are seeing, it appears real. And when you stop caring for it, it just dissolves. Now, that is what the jagat. Now, in this jagat, do you want to apply karana-karya-bhava? Means the cause-effect relation. You want to apply to the jagat? It is not a very wise thing to do. But many people do that. No, janmadyasya yataha, Brahma is the jagat karanam. That is said like that. Abhyupagamya, it is said. It is said like that, Brahma is the jagat karanam. Jagat is the karya, Brahma is the karanam. The karana karya bhava, the cause-effect relationship, which is proposed in that Brahma Sutra, etc. It is very provisional, Abhyupagamya Uktam. Because there the karana is the Brahma, is Chetanam, it is not Jada. And Chetana cannot be a transformative cause of the Jagat. It cannot be a transformative cause. Only Jada can be transformative cause. If you want to say both the cause and effect are real, and the cause transforms into the real effect, if that is what you want to look at it, then that kind of a transformation can happen only when the material is inert. It is insentient material. Sometimes it is described as though the description is not valid, but still people tend to describe it that clay is real, pot is real. The real clay has undergone a real transformation into the real pot. This is the cause-effect relationship. Do you want to look at God, the cause, and the jagat, the effect, in that light? Is that what you want to look at? That is how they look at. Many people, they look at it like that. Who are they? The Nayayikas, Vaisheshikas, the dualists, they are the Dvaitins. They look at it like this, just like what I said just now. God is there. And so then they have to bring in some other thing also, say Paramanu, etc., something else you have to bring in. There is a transformational causation for the Paramanus, which is happening under the direct control of God. That way you have to postulate. That is what they do. And whereas in Vedanta, when you say the Karana, it is not Nimitta Karanam, it is not the efficient cause. It is always the material cause. The word upadana, it is very unique to Vedanta. Whereas in the case of logicians like Vaisheshika and Nayayika, they use the, for them, karanam is nimitta karanam only. Karanam is nimitta karanam. They don't use the word upadana. They say some samavayi karanam, this and that. The upadana, upadana is the material. So Brahman is the upadana karanam of the jagat. That upadana is taken as the karanam by Vedantins. When Vedantins say karanam, it is only upadana. In fact, Vedantins are called upadana rasikaha. That is how they are called. So, therefore you say Brahma jagat karanam, it just means that Brahma is jagat upadana. It is the material of, it is the stuff of which the jagat is made. Now, this Brahma, is it chetana or jada? Now, if you say jagat is jada, that is obvious. When jagat is jada, the karanam, the upadana, the stuff of which, out of which the jagat is created, cannot be but jada. It has to be jada. That is the logic of the Sankhyas. That is how they proposed a jada entity, an insentient entity, called Pradhana as the jagat karanam. Whereas Vedantins are not saying like that. For them, Brahma is not jada, it is chetana. Now, Brahma being sentient, that is Chaitanyam, there cannot be any transformation in Chaitanyam. Transformation is possible only in the mat, in the material thing, not in the light. Why? You see, even the light outside is jada, but still it doesn't undergo any transformation. So, transformation is a process that happens only in the matter, which is very gross. Whereas even the light outside light, which is very subtle, it doesn't undergo any transformation. When the light is used to project a movie on the screen, the light alone is appearing as the scenes, nothing else. But the light is not undergoing any transformation. It remains just what it is, and yet it makes the scenes appear on the screen. So, when the light outside itself doesn't undergo the transformation, then the inner light, or the light which you call Brahma, the Chetana, Chetana is the light. The word light is metaphorically used. Therefore, the Chetana, Brahma, it cannot undergo any transformation. Therefore, Brahma as the transformational cause of the universe is ruled out. It is just not possible. Therefore, Brahma can only be an apparitional cause of this universe. Therefore, janmadhyasyataha, etc., though it doesn't specify whether it is transformational cause or apparitional cause, etc., and also it doesn't specifically say that the jagat is like a movie and all that, yet all that is abhyupagamya, all that is understood provisionally, jagat is presented as karanam. Therefore, the point that I am trying to make is, instead of hanging on to the cause-effect relation between Brahma and Jagat, that will not take you anywhere. Because there is this issue in cause-effect relation, the transformation is generally the cause-effect relation thing, the transformation, that is where you focus. But in this case, the transformation is not valid. And it is apparition, not transformation. Therefore, there is no point in hanging on to cause-effect model anymore. There is no point in it. Because as long as it is transformation, the language of cause-effect model means nice, it sounds nice. But when it is not transformation, better you give up the cause-effect model, that language, the terminology, you better give up. There is another issue there. In cause-effect model, the time becomes very important. Now the entire model is caught in the net of time. That is because karana is defined as karya niyata purva vritti karanam, that which is necessarily present before the effect is the cause. Therefore, cause is the one which was present earlier, effect is the thing that comes later. So now the whole thing is caught in the net of time. Not only the effect is in the net of time, but along with the effect, the cause is also caught in the net of time. But Brahma is understood as timeless. You see, if Brahman is transforming into the Jagat, at a given time, then time becomes the real Brahma. Because this Brahman is under the control of the time. Therefore, Brahman is timeless. This is another issue that Vedantins have with reference to cause-effect model. Therefore, though cause-effect model is talked about, janmadhyasyataha ityadi, it is very abhyupagamya, very provisionally it is talked about. The model that we really love is drugdrushya model. That is what the Maharshi is talking about. Okay? So, he comes to the drugdrushya model. Drushya is the jagat. Jagat is what is seen. That is what jagat is. What is seen? Now, there is only eyesight is not jagat. Only rupa is not the only thing that you call jagat. Shabda is also jagat. So what is heard is also jagat. What is tasted is also jagat. What is touched is also jagat. Therefore, the word seen it has to be given a wider meaning. Therefore, what is perceived is Jagat. Okay? Therefore, instead of, because Loka is there, you know, the Drug Drushya, the seer seen. Therefore, their seen is not just seeing alone with the eyesight. It is the perception, entire perception you have to take into account. And then mind has its own way of knowing things. Therefore, what you perceive and what you conceive, add that also. That is all the Lokya. So, that which is experienced. So, now what is the Jagat? What you see is the Jagat, but then what you perceive is the Jagat, but then expand its scope. What you experience, what you perceive and conceive, and then what you experience, that is what is the Jagat. Experience how? Experience through the sense organs and the mind. What you experience through the sense organs and the mind is the Jagat. Therefore, we can now say Jagat is relative to the sense organs and the mind. When the sense organs are functional, of course, with the association of the mind. Mind is in alignment with the sense organs. So the mind and the sense organs together are functional. And now appears the movie called Jagat. And now you apply the Anvaya Nishedha method. When the mind and sense organs function, the movie called Jagat is experienced. It appears or experienced. That is the positive way of looking at the Anvaya method. Now apply the Nishedha method. When the mind and sense organs are not functional for whatever reason, either you meditate or going to meditation or samadhi or whatever, or even deep sleep, so the Jagat doesn't appear anymore. The experience comes to a halt, it stops. Therefore, yad bhave, yad bhavaha, yad abhave, yad abhavaha. So, the mind and sense organs are functional, you experience the world. The mind and sense organs are non-functional, the experience of the world comes to an end. Therefore, what you call the world is not independent, it is not absolute, it is very much relative to the sense organs and the mind. Therefore, the sense organs and the mind together constitute the seer, vilokita, the seer, or the experiencer, and the Jagat is the experienced. Both are connected by what is called the experience. The experience connects the experiencer and the experienced. And this experience is like very much like a movie. That is what the Jagat is. So you have to put the Jagat in the right in its rightful place. You should not give a reality which it doesn't have. Only this much. It is there when I see it, when I take part in it, it appears real. It is there when I see it. When I do not see it is not there. Quantum mechanics, quantum physics, I tell you. When you see it is there. When you don't see it is not there. When you take part in it appears real. You see, what you see need not be real. For example, the movie that you see is not real. You know that. But all you see is not real. You know that. But the Jagat you take to be real. Why? You are seeing it. Therefore, it must be unreal. Drishyatvat. It is unreal because it is seen. Why don't you conclude like that? Whatever is seen is unreal. You should be able to conclude like that. Why it is not concluded like that? Because you take part in it. You take interest in it. And then selective interest. Some of them I like, some of them I hate. This kind of a divided interest. So, attachment versus aversion. So now you take interest of both positive interest and negative interest, or attachment and aversion, that kind of an involvement you get into. And thereby, now what appears, what is a mere appearance, is taken as though real. This is the problem associated with Jagat experience. So, Atra Chitre, in this movie, Lokyam, the Jagat, what is seen, the Jagat. See, Ravana Maharshi used to say, loka, bhuloka, swargaloka. These words are there, Vishnu loka. It is always the word loka. Look at the word loka and look at the word look. They are same, you know. They have originated from the same source. Otherwise you have to say Sanskrit has originated from English or the other way, whatever. In fact, they both have originated from one single source, what they call Indo-European language. So, loka, look, they are very close to each other. So, when you say lochanam is the eye, the ka becomes cha. The ka and cha, kavarga and chavarga, they get interconverted. Kuhosh, chuhu, choh, kuhu, whatever way you want it, it can happen. Therefore, what you look at is loka. Loka, lokyate iti lokaha. So, it is a karma vyutpatti. Lokyate iti lokaha. What is seen or what is looked at is loka. Bhulokaha, swarga lokaha, Vishnu lokaha. So, the name itself is very significant. And you see, somebody asked Ramana Maharshi, is Swargaloka real? That is the question. Now, what is the mindset behind that question? Is Swargaloka real? The mindset is Bhuloka is real. We are able to see that very much. Only we are not sure about Swargaloka. That is the question. So the answer to that question is, Ramana Maharshi asked him, is Bhuloka real? You tell that. Is Bhuloka real? Of course Bhuloka is real. Then Swargaloka is also real. Okay? But Bhuloka you say, no, Bhuloka is not real. Then Swargaloka is also not real. Like that. Therefore, in this movie called The Jagat, Lokyam. Lokyam is all the content of that movie called Jagat. That is the Lokyam. Okay? The entire content of the movie called Jagat. Then Lokyancha Vilokitacha. Vilokita is the seer, the one who is the subject. The Jagat is the object and you are the subject. What is the subject? Who is the subject? Is the subject Atma? No. The subject is not Atma. Subject is the mind only. Mind is the subject. Mind versus matter. What you call matter is the Jagat, and what perceives the matter is the mind. Mind versus matter. Now, mind is the subject, but then mind is Jada, matter is Jada. By itself it cannot shine. Therefore, there must be the light of knowledge or light of knowingness to make matter evident. So the matter must be illuminated by the light of awareness. That is equally correct in the case of mind also. Mind is also Jada, only subtle, that's all. And so the matter without is Jada, the mind within is also Jada. Now the matter without is object, the mind within is subject. So the subject is also Jada. But then the mind catches the reflection of that light of awareness, that inner light of awareness, and it is subtle, therefore it catches the reflection, and therefore it acquires the status of a subject, because being very subtle, it is able to catch the reflection of the Atma, the light of awareness, and therefore it has acquired the status of a subject because of its subtlety and its purity by which it is capturing the reflection of Atma. Okay? Whereas the matter cannot do it, therefore matter remains the object and clearly recognized as Jada. When it comes to the mind, you should be able to say that the mind is also equally Jada. Therefore, guna guneshu vartante, you know. So, therefore, mind and matter are of the same stuff, Jada. But it is the same Jada, the same unreal Prakruti is now acquiring the shape of the subject and object. therefore lokyancha vilokita cha, the subject and object. It is like the projector, the lens, projector lens is the vilokita. In the movie example, there is a projector lens and the screen. Under the screen is the jagat, take it like that. And what all appears on the screen, the scenes, are the content of the movie called jagat. And the lens, take it like that, okay? The example is, you have to suit the example to the point that is on hand. Therefore, the lens is the below subject. Lens is the subject. Lens also cannot shine by itself. The lens is the subject. And then the film is there. The film is the mind, moving mind. And lens together with the film, moving mind, is the subject. And the scenes on the screen, that is the jagat. That is the arrangement. Okay? Now only one thing is missing. Like the flight is filled with the passengers, the flight is ready, everything is ready, only pilot is not yet there. Only one thing is missing now. The lens and the movie film, they are in place, occupying the position of vilokita, and the screen is there in place, only the light is missing. So now you add the light. So the light of awareness, which is in you, which is in me, which is in every living being, pataha, the screen. Now, in the movie, there is the screen. In the darshtantika, the drishtanta, the screen, the scenes, the lens and the film is moving, the lens and the film, everything is there. Now, come to the darshtantika, the screen is the jagat. The content of the screen is the content of the jagat. The lens and the film together constitute the mind within, which is the subject, and also it is moving. Okay, mind is always moving. The mental states succeed one another. And that is how those successive mental states are projected outside as the content of the jagat. So all that is moving. Now, you have to provide a screen in the darshtantika. What is the screen in the darshtantika? The screen is the canvas of space-time. That is the screen. Got it? You see, suppose you see pot. Now, you see pot as an object. That is how you see. As though independent of space and time. As though independent. Object is object. Pot is an object. The cup is an object. Like that you see. But then, can you have an object without space? You cannot have object without space. What I mean is not that object is sitting inside the space. Not only that is there anyway. But object has a shape. The shape is nothing but space. A configuration within this space is called shape. So to be an object, it must have a shape. A physical shape or a mental shape. Some shape must be there. And the shape itself is a construct of the space. Without space, you cannot have a shape. And therefore, when you say an object, you cannot separate the object from the space. It is the object in space. And given a shape by the space. Therefore, the objectness is invariably associated with the space. And then time. Once space comes, time comes. Space-time is continuum, ayuta siddha they say. You cannot separate them. You have space, you have time also. Like nama-rupa, you have nama, you have rupa. Rupa need not be physical form, it could be a mental form also. Therefore, they are always together. You cannot separate them. So therefore, when you say part, the part is in this form. That is the shape, that is the space. At this point of time, here and now, that here, the space, now the time, are invariably associated with the thing called pot. Desha, kala, vastu, they are all always together. Therefore, you cannot have a vastu without the deshakala. Therefore, deshakala provide the screen or the canvas on which the world of objects is experienced. Therefore, now, what is the screen now? The space-time canvas is the screen. So, space-time canvas is the screen. The scenes are the scenes continuously changing, and one scene succeeding the other. These scenes constitute what is called the phenomenal world, and the mind and the sense organs, the moving mind and the sense organs together constitute the subject. So now the all the three are in place. Lokyancha, vilokitacha, patascha. Okay, that has come in place. Now only the pilot has to come. The stewardess is there, passengers are there. The aeroplane is ready, it is fueled, everything is ready, ready to go. And only the pilot is not there. So it happened to us one time, that's why I remember that illustration. Only pilot has to come. So similarly here, everything is in place, but the one thing without which all this everything is nothing, with which all this everything appears as though real, though it is not real, that one thing is prakashaha, the light of awareness, patav prakashaha api. So the light of awareness. Now come back to the movie example. Okay, so take the example, it like this: the light of the projector, inside the projector there is a very powerful light, a powerful bulb which gives the light. That light, okay, it falls on the lens and it illuminates the lens. Now you have to understand that that light conditioned by the lens, still light only, what you call lens. Lens is what? Light in a particular way focused, that is the lens. Therefore, lens is also light only. Then the film, so the light passes through the film, and in the process it gets conditioned by the imprints in the film. Right? Now, before entering the film, what is it? Light. After it emerges from the film, what is it? Light only. But still, the film has added its imprints, its images imprinted in the film are added as though to the light. Okay. Now this light, conditioned by the images of the film, falls on the screen. And so now what is on the screen? The light. Light will fall on the screen. Therefore there is light on the screen. But then there is hero, heroine, villain and scenes, everything is there. So all of them are light only. Okay? So you begin with light, pure light conditioned by the lens and the film, light appearing as the scenes on the screen. Okay? And the screen is also light only. Screen is light only, lighted screen it is. Take it like that. Okay? So everything is light. When you go to your movie, purchase a ticket and sit in a chair and start watching, it is all light and light and light and light and nothing else. Only light is there. Nothing else is there. Okay? What about me? You are absorbed. The illustration, you know. The illustration. You are absorbed in the movie. Okay? So only light is there. The light becomes the lens, the light becomes the imprints of the film, the light becomes the screen, the lighted screen, the light becomes the scenes. Only light is there. Everything is light. That light. Everything is light only. Okay? Nothing is light. Light is none of those things. Everything is light, but yet light is none of them. Okay, this is the Maya, this is the magic of a show. In the show, light is everything, but there is nothing in the light. Matsthani sarvabhutani, nacha matsthani bhutani. Everything. So here what happens is, when you look at everything, you have to see the one light in all. Okay? That is how you have to see. If you don't see it that way, then the all, the variety, the multiplicity, and then the opposites. Once there is variety and multiplicity, that multitudinous world gets divided into the opposites, good and evil, pleasure and pain, like that it gets divided. And as it is divided, it creates similar responses, attachment and aversion. So now you are part of the show. You are caught in the show. And in the process, you miss the real, the light. You miss it. That mistake should not happen. Therefore, to safeguard yourself from that bondage of samsara, that is this bondage of samsara, you take the variety and multiplicity as real, and then you project the divisions of the opposites, and believe that the opposites are real, and then get attached and averse towards the opposites, and thus you are caught in this mess of the unreal world. You are caught. Why you are caught? Because you fail to see the one light in all this appearance. That failure to see the one in all is the cause of the bondage. Okay? Now that is from the one side, one in all. Now look from the all side, so all this, you start from all this. Now all this is put in place by that one light, okay? But all this is not part of that light. All this doesn't exist in that light. Therefore, from the light side, when you come to the all, you have to see the same light in all, but from the all side you go to the light, you should be able to negate the all. That's why sarvam khalvidam brahma, there sarvam, the multifarious world is brahma, means what? The multifarious world is brahma, means what? Is the multifarious world an attribute to the brahma? No. That is not an attribute to the Brahma. That becomes some kind of a dvaita only. They call it advaita, but it is not advaita. It is dvaita only. So it is not an attribute to Brahma. It is an appearance that is upheld or blessed by the Brahma. That's all. And being an appearance, it is not real. And hence, it doesn't add to the Brahma. It doesn't stick to the Brahma. It doesn't affect the Brahma. It is not part of the Brahma. In simply saying, it is not there in Brahma. Therefore, sarvam khalvidam brahma, when you say, what is idam this jagat, what is taken as sarvam, is not real, is not sarvam, it is not idam, it is Brahma only. That kind of a badha, nishedha, you have to introduce a negation there. Sarvam khalvidam brahma is what is called badha samanadhikaranyam. It is not an attribute and the substantive being presented together. It is not that kind of a statement. It is not visheshana visheshya bhava. Okay? It is not attribute and the substantive. It is not that kind of a statement. It is a negation statement. So what you consider as idam, drushyam, and what you consider as multifarious, the sarvam, is neither idam nor sarvam. It is Brahma alone. So all of this sa ekaha, abhavat sa ekaha. Abhavat can be called bhavati also, because past tense in the mantras is always taken as the present tense. So if you want to talk about that at the time of creation, how it happened, you say abhavat, but when is the creation? Today morning is the creation. It is nitya srishti, nitya pralaya. And therefore bhavati. Abhavat becomes bhavati. Sa ekaha, that light. So you can easily apply it to yourself. We are talking of the Brahman, But whatever we talk of the Brahman, you have to apply to yourself, because it is Adhyatma Vidya. In fact, the Brahman is appreciated based on an understanding of yourself. You look at yourself, you wake up. So waking up means the window of the mind is slowly opening. The window of the mind. Till then, the window of the mind is closed. Means mind is not there. Okay, take it like that. The window of the mind is unreal, you know. Mind cannot be real. So the window of the mind, it is the real reflecting in the unreal. It is a satya anuruta mithuni karanam. It is a combination of the real and the unreal. The light of awareness, atma chaitanyam, and the mind, they come together. That is the combination of the real and unreal. Okay? So the mind is slowly opening. The window of the mind is opening. So the light of the sun of atma is flooding in. Okay? And now what all that is there in the mind comes to light. The mental states start shining in the light of that Atma Chaitanyam, in the light of that awareness. And the mind is not a single thing sitting there. Mind is a movement. Therefore, the succeeding mental states, one mental state succeeds the another mental states. All these mental states as they move forward. So the space and time are included. That when there is movement, space and time kick in. You cannot have a movement without space and time. Therefore, space-time get included, and the mental states are succeeding one another, and the light is flooding in, and all these mental states along with the movement come to light. And the experience, that the resulting experience is called the world. That is the world experience, Jagat experience. Therefore, you see, what you call world, see, there is nothing wrong with the world. What is everything is wrong with the way you look at the world. That is the problem. Like you look at the movie, you go to the movie. Once I went to the movie, and then all these fans came. They came with baskets of flowers and plenty of coins also. And when the actor comes onto the screen, they believe that the actor has come onto the screen. They clap and welcome the actor and throw the coins and throw the flowers. And I am sitting in a convenient chair and watching the movie and watching this disturbance also. I am a jnani and they are samsaris. Why am I a jnani? Because I am not throwing flowers and coins. Because I know that is a show. Unreal. But they believe it to be real. Therefore, nothing wrong with the show. Everything is wrong with the way you look at it. Therefore, the way you look at the world is all wrong. It is our imagination that misleads us. We imagine. And that imagination, it misleads us. I tell you, without imagination, there is no world. Without projection, there is no serpent. Projection is imagination only. Suppose you don't imagine, is there a serpent? No. Therefore, without imagination, there is no world. You see, you are convinced that you are seeing a world. You are knowing a world, you are experiencing a world, you are convinced that way. So your conviction that you are experiencing a world is the world. That is the world. There is no other world. So, therefore, the world that you perceive is made of that inner light, that awareness. And what you call matter is that inner light alone. That's why what you see, Aschuttarasyam Dishi Devatatma Himalayo Nama Nagadhiraja. So the Kalidasa. So Himalaya is there, the mountain. What is its essence? What is the essence of the mountain? What is the essence of the mountain? Atma is the essence, Sara. Like you don't answer. Look, you are looking at the movie screen, and the movie is going on. You are looking at the hero. Okay, he is dancing or whatever. And now, what is the essence of that hero? Light. That is the essence of the hero. But in the story, the essence of the hero is, as he is dancing, Shrungara is his essence. And if he is fighting the villain, Vera is his essence. Like that it appears. But are they his essence? Love is his essence? Or courage, or valor, prowess, all are they his essence? No. What is the essence of that hero? Light. Okay? Similarly, you are looking at Himalaya, the mountain. Himalaya is the name. Mountain. What is the essence of this mountain? Stone. No. The essence of the mountain is not stone. What is, you have seen a mountain in the dream. What is the essence of that mountain? The dream consciousness. That is the essence of that mountain. You see a mountain on the cinema's movie screen. What is the essence of that mountain? Light. In the waking state, you are looking at the mountain. What is the essence of that mountain? The waking consciousness. Which is like the light reflected through the lens. Like that. That is the waking consciousness. The inner light of Atma Chaitanyam, which is reflected through or in the mind, that is the waking consciousness. And the waking consciousness now takes the shape of mountain. Therefore, through the waking consciousness, the light of awareness, the timeless, spaceless, one without the second, light of awareness, that is the essence of the mountain that you are experiencing. You say it is the mountain, it doesn't say I am the mountain. Therefore, the mountain is the mountain that you are experiencing or that you are perceiving. And the essence of that mountain that is being perceived by you is the light in you. Therefore, that is the essence. And that light is called Devata. That's why Devata Atma. Ascuttarasyandishi Devata Atma. Himalayo Nama Nagadhi Raja. Like that the story goes. Therefore, what you call matter is consciousness. What you call mind is of course consciousness, waking consciousness. The waking consciousness alone appears on both sides. On one side as the subject, on the other side as the object. You both are the same waking consciousness. When you go to sleep, there is neither the subject nor the object. When you wake up, both the subject and object spring up together. They come up together. They sink or vanish together. Both have the same origin. And that origin is that light pure, which is the Atma. And the name of that light is Atma or Brahma or God or Krishna or Rama. That is that light. That light happens to be the pure being also. It is the existence absolute. It is the awareness absolute. And when you abide in it, there is that boundless peace and a sense of fullness in you that is called Ananda. That is the verse. Okay? So, let us say the verse one time. सर्वैर निदानं जगतो हमश्च वाच्यः प्रभुः कश्चिदपार शक्तिः चित्रेत्र लोक्यञ्च विलोकिता च पटः प्रकाशोऽप्यभवत् स एकः. I am concluding. So Maharshi, he refrains from giving a name and form to it. He says Saha, Ekaha. So Prakashaha. Prakashaha is Pumlinga. That's why he said Saha, Ekaha. Otherwise, he doesn't mean that a male god or any such thing. He doesn't give a form. He is not in a hurry to give a form and a name. he uses the most non-sectarian language. He doesn't prejudge anything. Okay? You discover that light. You have to discover it in yourself. And so, the language is very precious. People, they are in a big hurry. They want to give a form to that light. They give a form and make it human, human form. The humanism, you know. So, the Rishi, the Maharshi, he doesn't do all that. He refrains from that weakness of the mind. That is the weakness of the mind. Unless you give a form to it, you give a label to it, and you categorize it, like putting it in a pigeon hole, then the mind will be at ease. This is the weakness of the mind. So leave it open, open-ended. Prakashaha saha ekaha. That is how the Rishi talks. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam. Tell you the truth, Sri Anubhavanandaji is sitting in the class. He made me uneasy, I tell you, that is the truth.